One thing you can do if there's like too much with the arrows there, and box nothing from this deck would look like this. You've got three things that you're shooting, and so. powers. Power of the powers. 3, 2, 1, 0. They're decreasing by one every time. But the second term, Y is on these as well. What's the pattern on those powers? So again, here's what's going on. Here's how we can get away with getting our answer without doing any. But this time, we would look at the power on the wrong. We would go to the corresponding row of the triangle with one row below the actual power. So the power 3 being row 4. That would be our coefficients. We would take the first term, put it everywhere, and then decrease the power of the exponents. But how do we know what to start with? What is this number? And then the second term goes on everything but its exponents increase. And so one thing I want you to add on your Pascal triangle here is a column for your exponent. And please write your exponent up here. If your problem, our original problem, like the exponent of 3, and that was this row right here. That was the fourth row that is the power of 3. And the reason why that happens like that is in order for something to simplify to 1 with an exponent, what is that exponent? 0. Okay, so the first row is actually for a 0 power. And then 1 power is this one, 2 power is this one. And you can make as many rows as you need. This only went to power of 5. If your problem was power of 6, you would just make an additional row. You can add the stuff up again to get your exponent. And I want to show you, even from the problem we just did, another example of this. Right here, where we did the first two binomials, x plus y times x plus y, that's really x plus y squared. And what coefficients did we get when we did the square? We got 1, 2, 1. Right? And when you look at Pascal's triangle, for power of 2, or 1, 2, 3. And x plus y to the first power, x squared is our n of 1. X plus y to the 0 power, that is p1. Okay, so those patterns are called 0 and 1. So what we're about to do is use Pascal's triangle, and those patterns of the exponents of 1 going down and 1 going up, we're going to redo this problem without the math. So this is the same problem, x plus y cubed. And even though we already know the answer is going to be, I'm still going to walk you through this mental work. The first thing would be, what's the tower in the problem? Right? So we're going to ask those triangles. So we'll find the row for the third exponent, which is 1, 3, 1. We're going to write those down with a bunch of space in between because we want to fill in the answers. So 1, 3, 3, 1. The next thing you're going to take the first term. What's the first term in our binomial? Just the term by itself. X. Negative anything in X. And we said for that first term, the exponents are going to be decreasing by one each term. But what will it be starting with? 3, because that's the power on the problem. So we're going to start with 3 and decrease it all the way here. And then now we put the second term on there. What's the second term? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 push X one of those lines, so. And then we simplify anything that can simplify. So for example, on the first term, we don't have to keep that one in our answer, and why don't we have to keep y to the zero? Because it's just one, right? So then I just need to keep that x cube. Because otherwise, if x cube comes up to one, we can still. Plus 3x squared y, plus 3x y squared, plus 11. It's the same thing. So that is using Pascal's triangle for binomial expansion. And we're going to do one more problem as part of the test. Same thing we just did. What's up with this problem? What's so different about this one? Okay. Yeah, this coefficient is a variable, right? What else? The x1 is different. X1 now is 4. And the 2 instead of a variable. Okay. So what those exponents and that 2 means, we will have to do a little bit more math on this problem than the last one, which is only about variables. The basic idea is still the same. So the first question is, what's the power in the problem? 4. So go over your Pascal's triangle and find which row you need to form coefficients, or the coefficients in the row. That's the row, right? Remember the coefficient. It's 1, it's 4, and it's 4, it's 4. But it's not the number 5. It's the fifth row we are in the top. The very first row is 0. Alright, so we got our coefficients. Then we put the first term down everywhere. What is the first term? 3a. That entire term. Okay, so everything is a 3a. In the first term, is that high to low exponents or low and high? High to low, then what will this one be starting with? 4. And then everything gets the second term. What's the second term? So now when you're going to simplify stuff, for your order of operations, you do exponents first, right? I know you can do all this and it's fine, but I just want to be sure you're clear on how to do the exponents for the base of 3a. 3a to the fourth means 3a times 3a times 3a times 3a. So it's 3 fours, 4 threes, and 4 a's, right? So 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 is a 1, and a to the fourth is a 4. Times 1, which doesn't mean anything to change. Times 2 to 0, what is 2 to 0?
4.
1. So it's changing anything. So the first term is done. The second term, I'm not doing anything with that just for, because that's a multiplication, and board of operations is a good exercise for. I'm gonna do that for, just to bring it down. But I do need to figure out 3AQ. The rest of this is just multiplying the coefficients. Just more of a multiplying, like 4 times 27 times 2. 6 times 9 times 4. Also, wait a minute, and you do that, and I'll show you the answer.